The 2016 Junior Super Soft Camp, sponsored by Children's Healthcare of Atlanta, dedicated to all better. CBA Sports, your sports construction specialist. Crossover, get your game brain on. And Miller Grove Men's Basketball, Reclaiming the Crown documentary.
And welcome back here to Atlanta as we get ready to transition from the top 40 game to the top 20 edition. Marcus Burnett joined by David Dickerson here on the mic, also known as at Hoop Kids there on the web. Appreciate you joining us. Hey man, we roll on from top 40 into top 20. Some of the players you're looking forward to watching here in this game, and I'll include the caveat, I know that won't be an exhaustive list, too much talent to really sum up, but give us your thoughts on some of the players you're looking forward to watching.
Gosh, there's so many of them. The 10 that are out there on the floor, Christian Matthews, a 6'6 dynamo out of South Carolina, our outstanding prospect at Fab Frosh last year, just tearing things up on the circuit. We have everybody from Ashton, number 58, who is a Georgia kid, Georgia Stars, who is also one of the most outstanding players in the country in his age group, Ashton Hagens. Look for big things for Ashton. At the guard with the ball right now, Marcus Joseph Girard. Very impressive, one of the top guards in the country, and has really came here and proved himself.
I think that guy didn't like how he wasn't one of the first names mentioned.
Actually, he was. Okay. That was Christian Brown, number 17, out of South Carolina. Great player. A lot of energy.
Remember him having a great Fab Frosh camp there at West Georgia last year. So I think that's what's good about catching him at Fab Frosh. Nine times out of 10, you know to expect those same types of players at the Super Soft. Going into that year, always nice to see the benchmarks in terms of how their game has grown over the course of that year.
Yeah, absolutely. And then we get some of the surprise kids who maybe weren't invited. The Fab Frosh who have great freshman years. And all these kids that we're looking at, Marcus, by the way, are kids that contributed very heavily to their varsities as ninth graders, as freshmen.
Joseph Girard contributing to the game with that triple. Now, I remember touching base with one of his relatives here in the stands. They said that he's out of New York. Now, is he any relation to the head coach, Girard, of the Yankees? Would you happen to know that?
No, I don't think that's the case. But I'm sure that if Girard saw how well he played, he wouldn't mind that association.
Wouldn't mind claiming him.
Absolutely.
He's at a good camp so far. I'll have a trip to the free throw line coming here. This is number 28. That's Josh Nickelberry.
Josh Nickelberry has been not necessarily the surprise of the camp, but he has probably been the number one player in camp this year. Out of North Carolina, unbelievable. The kid does everything well. Scores at a clip that you would not believe. Had a couple 40-point nights here already. Starting to the recruiting heat is starting to be turned up on him. I expect very soon for him to have some offers. I think he just got out of Virginia Tech since he's been here, there was another school, but don't be surprised if you hear the big North Carolina schools offering him very shortly. And these are rising sophomores, folks. Let me classify that for you. They're going into the 10th grade, and they're already being heavily recruited.
You mentioned Nickelberry being from North Carolina. Obviously, you're based there in that DMV area, but you see a ton of talent from around the country. Talk about North Carolina as a hotbed for basketball. Dating to the past days to even now.
Yeah, I think that what we're seeing in North Carolina because of the advent of what's happening with circuit ball. We don't really talk about AAU anymore. We talk about circuit ball. We talk about the programs that are sponsored by the sneaker companies, by Nike, Adidas, and Under Armour now. Has really increased the level of play. Kids are traveling more. Kids have exposure to very good training, the best equipment. And so places like North Carolina, you know, which in many ways is always have always been hotbeds, but we're seeing in Greensboro and the Greensboro High Point area, you know, Durham has always been strong. We're seeing those places have a bevy of talent now. And maybe in the past, Marcus, those kids were playing football. Yeah. And they're not anymore.
Ashton Hagens knocks that one down, representing Newton County High School here, about 20 minutes north of the Atlanta area. That young man right there, that's number 60. Patrick McCaffrey.
Patrick McCaffrey is the son of Fran McCaffrey, coach at Iowa. Former Siena coach and former Farley Dickinson coach. Heck of a player.
Quick hands right there by Gerard. Thought they might have a mouse in the house. Gerard quickly rips it away, helps push it. And then the aforementioned McCaffrey with the lay-in. Ties us up at 11 apiece as we are just under the 10-minute mark. Big fella in need of a lifeline. He'll swing it. Footing lost momentarily. Brown going to try a three-pointer. Knocks it down. Talk about some of the development you've seen from Brown. Obviously, that athleticism, that ability to slash and finish above the rim, nothing new. What are some of the areas you've seen him get better in as Girardi splashes?
Well, he does a little bit of everything well. You know, right now, and this is early in the game, he shoots the ball okay. He's not a great shooter at this point. But he does everything well. And the biggest thing about him, about this kid, and what everybody loves about him is he loves to play. I mean, he enjoys playing. He smiles. He has fun. And he has what's called in the business a motor. I mean, he's nonstop, up and back, side and forth. You can't beat his energy. A little break in the action here.
Looks like subs are being called for. But I'm thinking.
I don't know if someone, did someone get hurt? No? Okay. We're all good. A little turnover here. Ball goes back to the white team.
14-16 here early on. But as you can see, under the 9-minute mark, jumper off the mark, long rebound. Possession retained by the white squad. Ashton Hagens with the rebound. Power dribble by the big fella, tries to muscle it up, fouled on the play. He will earn a trip to the line.
Yeah, he is a great young player. Out of the Richmond area, and had until very recently had actually been coming up and playing in the Washington area with Team Takeover. Wendell's a really skilled kid. You can see he's 6'10" and he's still growing. I think he's just turned 15. He's now back in Richmond area playing for Team Loaded.
See him get the rebound there. Now gets it over to Hagens. Hagens looking to work against Nickelberry. Big fella showing off the versatility.
Big shot, Wick Wendell. You mentioned Hagens before because Hagens is an Atlanta area kid. He's also leading. He's been leading the EYBL in scoring. I mean, he's had some big games. He's literally been unstoppable for Georgia Stars this year.
We'll have some substitutions coming in on both sides.
Mass subs now. Making sure guys get time. A lot of great young players coming in as well. I'm very familiar with, from my backyard, number 15, Justin Moore, who was a freshman, who played very well this year at DeMatha High School, the storied program in Washington, D.C. Great young player, has performed unbelievably well here at this camp. And really setting himself up to be one of the top players in the country.
You know, you mentioned DeMatha. It triggers my thoughts on some of what I love about these types of camps. You have the guys that have a little bit more notoriety around their name coming into it, and you have some guys that really take advantage of the stage. But it's all about where you end up, and I think just playing chess when it comes to developing your game. You mentioned DeMatha. It made me think of Markel Fultz. Mm-hmm. And just, you know, provide a summary of that situation and why it's a perfect example of, man, just work on your game.
Well, you know, it's somewhat of a myth, and maybe I shouldn't even say this on a stream television. Let me tell you, I've known Markel since he was a middle school kid. He could flat out always play. Played with my nephew in middle school. The problem was is that in going to DeMatha, you know, where many of the kids are some of the most recruited kids in our area, that he just was not a known entity. And so when he gets to the school, it was real obvious right away to Coach Jones and his staff that they had a player there, but literally he had to wait his turn because there were kids who had already been in the fold and there had already been commitments to those kids. But he is such a great kid and a great worker. He never complained. He just worked harder. But make no mistake about it, he could always play. I mean, he was an impact type of player. And I have gotten a lot of feedback from my NBA friends, Marcus, and we're talking about a kid that's already, they're talking about for next year's draft being a top five draft pick. So, my hat's off to him. He's a great kid. He just works hard, very difficult to stop. He just does some things that you can't teach. You can't ever teach.
Like how he stayed put at a good program. Sometimes you just got to wait your turn.
Mm-hmm. Well, in today, kids are not, don't do that. Everything is age appropriate. You know, you play, if you're 12 years old and you play 14s, that's a really big deal. So it's a different scenario now. But he just put in the work. He went to school every day. Very good student at DeMatha as well. Great kid, was in the gym with us about a week ago.
That one knocked out of bounds, looked like it was touched last by the Blue Squad. So I was sub in number 71, checking into the game. Michael Moreno.
Yeah, Mike's out of Kentucky, I want to say Louisville area. Very impressive this week. Can really shoot the ball. Nice size, 6'6", 6'7", kid.
Big fella had the chair pulled out from under him. That'll be a traveling violation and send it the other way. It's Oscar Shibwa on the moon.
Absolutely.
It's an 8-point game now. Blue Squad threatening to possibly turn this one to double digits. Anthony Harris with it now. Nice pass. Finish.
Big pass. And Harris, a great young player out of the Washington area over at Paul. There's Justin Moore, who we were talking about earlier from DeMatha. And Harris out of the Washington area as well. And he's at one of DeMatha's rivals, Paul the Sixth in Fairfax, Virginia. Had a great freshman year.
Take a look at that last connection. There, as you can see, Harris on the drive. Good vision, wraps around the blue jerseys and Jordan Wright. Pass is only as good as the play that ends up making it a bucket. And Wright is able to lay that one in.
That's it. You know what they say, you know, it's not a good pass if your teammate didn't catch it.
Can easily have a dime downgraded to a nickel if the layup isn't made.
That's it.
20-29 ball game. Catch and shoot. Moreno off the mark. Long rebound chased down, so they'll get another crack at it here on this possession.
Love this kid that just shot the jump hook out of Florida. Big kid, Anderson. Does a lot of things well. He's got a big future. Look for Florida, Florida State to come calling very quickly. He's from that Tampa area.
Ball last touch by Team White. Their advantage now 11 points. Appreciate you joining us here on SUV TV, the super soft camp here at the beautiful campus of Maynard Jackson. Talk about the players that get better each year, that this school and the area around it gets better each time we come here for the super soft camp as well. You got new loft developments, some retail stores coming in, just a great venue.
Yeah, absolutely. Neighborhood changing, so to speak. But beautiful retail development across the street with the Kroger's and a few other well-known national retailers.
It's Atlanta, so you know Waffle House is over there as well. Wouldn't be right without it.
Waffle House is everywhere, except for in the north. One of my favorite things to do, even going back to my Hampton days, was Waffle House, and we don't have them in D.C. You got to go to Delaware, or you got to come to Virginia. Nowhere in between.
That's tough, man. 16-point game. Shot off the mark.
Bad miss. Moreno is a great shooter. That was probably not the best shot. There he is, Lawrence.
A little bit of weight room move there.
That's it. Nice baseline move.
Right with the reverse. Can't get this one to go. About 33 seconds or so on the game clock.
There we go again. Quick pass. Anderson with the nice pass. Well, you know, one of the things that you could stop some of the baseline moves by cutting off the baseline. That's one of the things we try to teach with these kids, is to take that away, and you don't get the scoops and the dipsy doodles and the hooks.
And for guys that love to go baseline, there's a big difference between a guy that's really cutting that baseline off and a guy that's just kind of getting close to it and letting you slither around there.
Absolutely.
Big difference in truly cutting it off and sort of doing it lukewarm. So that is going to send us into halftime. We'll step away for a quick second. When we get back, we'll bring you more Super Soft Camp Top 20 games.
The 2016 Junior Super Soft Camp, sponsored by Children's Healthcare of Atlanta, dedicated to all better. CBA Sports, your sports construction specialist. Crossover, get your game brain on. And Miller Grove Men's Basketball, Reclaiming the Crown documentary.
And welcome back here as we are underway here in the second half. Team Blue versus Team White. It's Team Blue with an 18-point advantage. Threatening to pimp the ride in this one, putting it on Dubs. We're going to have a trip to the free throw line as the White team is at a good spot if they're to try to reverse this here in the second half.
Yeah, DJ Burns tried to get a nice little jump hook in there and got fouled. Missed his foul shot.
From the top of the key, off the mark, 2 for $1 sale. That one's short.
Yeah, that was Josh Nickelberry, missed that one. Oh, what a great try to tip pass by Christian Brown.
Mulcahy goes behind the back, drops it off. First layup no good, but following up with it, assistance paying off.
Big Wendell runs the floor as well as anybody in the country. He is a really impressive kid. I understand from his guys with Team Loaded that he got a couple offers just since he's been here in the camp.
Roddy, long rebound out to Mulcahy. Mulcahy driving baseline. Good pass out, and the three-pointer knocked down by number 28 there.
Nickelberg, Josh Nickelberg, that's what he's been doing all weekend. He also told me he's a cousin of a good friend of mine, current Howard coach Kevin Nickelberry, and former Hampton coach Kevin Nickelberry, one of the best recruiters in the country. So he gets it honest.
Good pedigree there. Christian Brown knocks down that three-pointer and then puts the guns back in the holsters.
Yeah, and I hope Kevin's listening. Kevin gave his young cousin the first Division I offer he got from Howard University, and I'm sure he expects to get his cousin. But I think his cousin and his parents, they're gonna have a lot more.
Yeah.
There's Christian Brown. They're gonna have a lot more offers than Howard. This kid was extremely impressive. He just hit that three. Joseph Girard, third, out of upstate New York, plays for the Albany City Rocks. He can play. I had heard about him. I had no idea that he was that good. He's a tough kid. He's a smart kid. Knows the right way to play basketball, how to involve his teammates.
I should run a couple laps. He's Girard. I asked the Girardi question earlier. I guess my mind is just on baseball, man. I'm an Atlanta Braves fan. So,
uh-oh.
You got to understand, I'm a little bewildered when it comes to baseball right now. We're struggling a little bit.
Yeah, struggling a little bit. you can think good thoughts that I've had a chance to see that stadium and what's going on out there. So that's going to be something to look forward to go out to the new spot.
That is our focal point. That is our story, and we are sticking to it here in the Atlanta area.
Yeah,
Nickelberry.
Forget the team, just the new stadium.
Yeah, great new digs coming. Does Nickelberry believe they're just going to say that was blocked out of bounds, no foul called on the play, so they'll just inbound it there along the baseline. I actually heard that here at Maynard Jackson, they had Hank Aaron, head coach for Michigan football, Jim Harbaugh, just a couple of the guys here on campus for a football camp a few days ago. So,
wow.
Just a lot of, top-tier talent, whether it's at the coaching ranks, former playing ranks, or the current players you see here on the floor. It's good company to be in terms of visitors to Maynard Jackson High School here this week.
Yeah, you talked about hotbeds, and not only just Maynard Jackson, but Atlanta. One of the things that's going on here, Marcus, as you know, and you guys are involved in, is the fact that you have a really unified media scouting athletic promotion group. And it's loosely organized because there's several different groups. Everybody from what Horace does to Corey Cooper. I saw Corey flash through with Court Cred, and my organization's done some stuff with Court Cred. Do a great job of getting the word out about the athletics here.
Yeah.
And particularly now with basketball, we've always known you guys to be a great football area, but with basketball, and it's really been responsible for people knowing about the Kobe Simmons of the world, who was a McDonald's All-American here this year out of St. Francis, and did the Jaylen Browns. People found out about them because of that this loosely structured group, and I of course put SUTV in that group as well. Really putting the word out that these kids can play.
Yeah, man. Couldn't agree with you more. A lot of talent coming out of this area. I've been in Atlanta for about 10 years, but from Indiana originally.
Mm-hmm.
Felt like basketball should have a much bigger platform here. I know football is king here in the South, but
right.
A lot of good hoopers here inside and outside the perimeter in Atlanta. So it's great to be a part of the media contingent responsible for making sure the masses get to see it on a regular basis.
Well, one of my former high school counselor and one of my mentors, I'm going to give him a shout out, Michael Lovett, is an Indianapolis guy who told me that anywhere there's basketball, there's someone from Indiana. He wanted me to me to know that anywhere there's been the growth of basketball in an area, it means that somebody from Indiana got there first. And I'd have to agree with him. There's just such a basketball culture. You ride through the flatlands of anywhere in Indiana where you can see for miles, and there's a basketball hoop at every farm, driveway,
yep,
that you can imagine.
It could be two 90-year-olds living in that house. There's going to be a hoop in the driveway.
Right, and they're going to shoot, and they'll be out shooting baskets.
Good pass there by Gerard. They can't get the finish, though. Also, that DJ Burns scored that last time down the floor for the white squad with the lady.
Yeah, he's had a great camp as well. I've been really impressed with DJ. I hadn't seen a lot of him. There's the Gerard kid we were talking about out of New York, up from the Albany area.
Our first 4-point play of the day is in terms of the All-Star games. Easy one for the official to call. Ice cream, go Gerard.
Yeah, he's going to I expect for one of the Northeastern colleges to snap him up for Boston College. Not maybe the prototypical Syracuse guy, because, you know, you got to be 6'6", 6'7".
Got to fit in that zone.
Yeah, man. to play guard in that zone.
Maybe he can get a little, you know, a little McNamara type niche there.
Yeah, he might might be. He's certainly tough enough.
Fighting for it. Like to see guys still going after those rebounds like that. They put a lot of wear and tear on their bodies. Yes, they're young, mm-hmm, but you're going against some of the best in the country, and you're going at it trying to earn a spot in these games and take advantage of the media outlets there. Chin up on the rim.
That's a great pass there.
That's our fella Oscar. Harris, strong move to create a little bit of space with that shoulder, floated up and over.
Yeah, Harris going to be a good player this year at Paul the Sixth, which is a very good national program coached by Glenn Ferrello. Had V.J. King this year, who you might remember, who's been through our camp. V.J. came. V.J. actually left or originally started out in Charlotte and then played at LeBron James's alma mater, St. Vincent's, St. Mary's, and then finished out at Paul the Sixth last year, made McDonald's All-American and headed to Louisville with Rick Pitino.
What impact have you noticed from that league?
It's
the WCAC. That was a nice shot there by Harris. And those guys playing with that shot clock. What difference have you noticed there?
Well, it's huge because, first of all, the kids are absolutely college ready because they're doing pretty much the same thing that the colleges are doing. But the other part of it is, and it's not even a discussion anymore. The WCAC, the Washington Catholic Athletic Conference, has the best high school basketball in the country, top to bottom. Even the teams that are performing in the bottom of the conference have three or four Division I players on them. And it makes a huge difference. The competition level is such that you just don't know whether you're gonna. There's no given.
Yeah.
There's no given wins. It's really tough. That and I put behind it the Chicago Public League group, which is again another just a super super competitive league. And it's even more. What's even more impressive, Marcus, is the fact that you know what's happening in Chicago. You know, with violence, with guns, that these kids are able to to work around that. Really, shout out to all of our kids from Chicago who have come through the camp. Take my hat off, Ben Coupe, one of the kids that came through. Fab Frost and Super Soft recently signed with UNLV. Just a great kid who stayed in touch. He and his dad stayed in touch over the years since his time here. And then Zach Norville out of Simeon played with him, headed to Gonzaga this year. I mean, these kids are really, you know, they're dodging a lot of stuff just to play basketball on a high level. So I want to make sure I give those guys a shout out. It's they're dealing with an extra component from a lifestyle perspective to be good players.
Justin Moore is making, knocking down the three ball part of his lifestyle as he's got back-to-back jumpers. That last one splashes through as this one is easily gotten out of hand. At this point, guys just playing just on from a pride standpoint on making sure they don't, you know, they don't wrap it
That's
up.
That's right. Well, Justin's, you know, I think Justin's going to have a big year this year. Of course, Markel Fultz headed out to University of Washington. He'll step in that role as a two guard. And another young man who didn't make it down here from DeMatha, who's tearing up the Under Armour circuit, Marvin Price is putting up, you know, just amazing numbers out there. He'll be there as a scoring option. So DeMatha is going to be tough. And I heard from Jesse today, Jesse McMillan at Norcross High School, that DeMatha is coming down this year to play in his tournament.
Loaded.
That he does.
Corners invitation.
Absolutely. Loaded. And I know you know that very well. So they'll be down, as well as Bishop O'Connell in Alexandria, Virginia. Bishop O'Connell is coached by Joseph Wooten, Morgan Wooten, the legendary DeMatha coach's son. We got a very good team.
Great family tree there, man.
Absolutely.
I remember watching Melo Trimble back when he was there, back a few years back, one of the tournaments we covered.
Yeah, Melo, of course, going to be coming back to Maryland this year. Had a great career at Bishop O'Connell.
Yep.
Another young man, shout out to Aiko Adams, who's comes out of O'Connell and is a is an alumnus of Fab Frosh and Super Soft. Aiko is headed to Rice University in Houston this year. Had a great 4-year career. Played the first 2 years with Melo, and now is going to be playing at Rice.
We talked about that Peachtree Corners Invitational. I want to give Jesse McMillan a shout out, man. Mother Nature, all due respect, Mother Nature. You did Jesse McMillan and the Norcross program wrong during last year's Peachtree Corners Invitational. Such a great lineup he had lined up. We had a matchup where we were going to see Bam Adebayo against Wendell Carter. You know, that's just one. As Anthony Harris takes off and yams one home.
Anthony Harris, again, a WCAC kid. Paul of six. But as do many of the nice dunk there from our guy. Jordan Wright out of Louisiana. Jordan back for his second year. He was at Fab Frosh last year. Nice jump shot there coming from Josh Anderson out of Florida in the corner. Oh, when we get back-to-back scoring now from Jordan out of Louisiana.
Right with a five-piece nugget.
Now, he's a kid that we've gotten to see grow a little bit, and literally grow, because he's gotten bigger, and he could play, but now we're seeing some other things, because he's probably added 2 inches since last summer.
Harris looking to take off as when he kind of gathered that ball in. It was like, hey, you guys have an invitation to join me at the rim if you want to.
Yeah,
you
but
know, I'm not sure if you want it.
Yeah, you're not sure if you want to get thrown into the cup. At the same time that I dunked the ball, he's a talent. And I think he'll be big this year too, because he's in a position where he's going to be replacing you know, the scoring load that was handled by VJ King, who's headed to Louisville. Good block.
Alley-oop attempt denied there. Not on my watch, says number 66. Justin McCoy.
Yeah, and that's our kid that you know, really impressed me with his shooting. North Carolina kid. On the miss, Messiah, little Messiah. Messiah has really grown literally as a player. He got a few inches. You can see he's still small, but he has played well. I love him. He's a Georgia kid, Messiah Thompson. Nice dunk there.
Bruce Scott Jr.
Yeah, I didn't know a lot about Bruce until this weekend from Tennessee, one of the Memphis kids. And I believe he comes out of not Penny's program, who has a team down in Memphis, but
Team Thad, maybe?
It might be Tim Thad 16s. Of course, you have a local kid that is playing for Team Thad this year, Drew Drennan, who you're going to see. I think you're going to see a lot of him here in the Atlanta area. He's been down, he was playing for Coach David, the legendary Coach David Boyd down in Milton High School, who was originally from Milton, as you where you know him. But, of course, he's been at East, down in Athens.
Yep.
I can't think of the name of the school.
Yeah, East Jackson High School.
East Jackson, yep. There you go. Coach Boyd retired now. Looks like he, after probably 40 years, nice place. I see all of his pictures. A nice place down in St. Simon Island that he's at now. Well, that's the end of this one. Great game. A little imbalanced on the scoring side, but I think that the viewers got a chance to see some of the kids that they're gonna see here on a regular basis here. Not only on all the high school rankings, but they're going to see these kids on television in very short order. And they can say, I saw them win.
I agree, man. Appreciate you joining us here on SUV TV. We're going to wrap this one up.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you for being on. You can follow him on Twitter, at HoopKids. I thank you, David Dickerson. Thank you. And so does the young man, Ant Harris, as he gives you his sentiments there with that dunk.
All right.
Appreciate you joining us here. I'm Marcus Burnett. He's David Dickerson, signing off from Atlanta. David.